Black-owned independent bookstores have been experiencing a surge in sales after the Black Lives Matter movement ignited interest in Black history, white supremacy, and how to end racism. Marcus Books, the oldest Black-owned bookstore in the country, has been there for its community through decades of similar challenges. Now, in its 60th year, it stands as a testament to an extraordinary couple's love of books and the Black community.
I still have Professor Blake's little book, you know, a little small poetry book.
This small Black-owned bookstore in Oakland, California is hallowed ground for some.
When I walked into Marcus Books as an African-American man, I had a sense that I belong somewhere.
Clarence Block Jr. grew up in San Francisco and has been coming here for almost 50 years.
Seeing books written about me and my ancestors filled a void.
Marcus Books was founded in 1960 by two visionaries, Julian and Ray Richardson. They believed that access to Black literature was paramount to the Black community. Their daughter Blanche Richardson runs the bookstore today.
Part of the basis of their relationship was their love of literature when they were teenagers, and it stayed like that. I mean, they always read together. They read to each other. They just had a love of books.
The couple met in the late 1930s at a unique school in Alabama dedicated to Black self-reliance.
You have to put Marcus Books and Julian and Ray Richardson really in the historical context. They both were at Tuskegee University, led by Booker T. Washington, who espoused the philosophy of do for self. Julian Richardson studied lithography. He met his wife there.
Jasmine Johnson is a granddaughter of the Richardsons and a professor of Africana studies at the University of Pennsylvania.
At an incredibly young age, she started college, not only meeting my grandfather, but becoming a woman of the mind.
The intellectual and artistic impact of the Harlem Renaissance was building momentum.
And they would really scour the country looking for books about Black people. At that time, very few Black people were being published. My parents saw the need for Black people to have a source of information about themselves.
After a few years in Harlem, the couple headed west and settled in San Francisco. It was 1946, and Julian started Success Printing.
They were, you know, publishing all kinds of things, posters, artwork, but they were also republishing Black books that had gone out of print. And Success Printing, that then turned into Richardson Printing, that then turned into Marcus Books.
In 1960, the Richardsons opened the bookstore, later renaming it Marcus Books after Marcus Garvey, founder of the Black Nationalist Movement. Both their fathers had been Garveyites. A critical cultural and intellectual space was born, fostering a natural gathering place for Black people.
It was a meeting place for many organizations, but also a place that appreciated you, welcomed you, did not follow you around the store with mirrors on the walls, you know.
When I came in, Julian Richardson, extremely humble, he would be walking out to check on me. Hey, well, Walter, what are you thinking? What are you reading?
Meanwhile, the neighborhood, known as the Fillmore District, was becoming a thriving center of Black life.
On Fillmore Street and the side streets, it was like a Harlem of the West Coast. Because not only were there jazz clubs and blues clubs, as you get to the later part of the 1960s, the office of the Black Panther Party was going to be on that particular street. It really represented the Black community.
The Fillmore Street location would be home to generations of the Richardson family.
I grew up in one big purple Victorian on Fillmore Street. There was the Marcus Books on the bottom on the storefront. My grandmother, aunt, at some point cousins on the second floor. You know, everybody was responsible to each other and to this broader commitment, which is about Black literacy.
But that commitment would be sidelined as the city's efforts to redevelop meant the destruction of the neighborhood, forcing the store and the family to move multiple times. In 1976, the Richardsons opened a second store in Oakland. It was the height of the Black Power Movement when the FBI's COINTELPRO program was surveilling Black businesses.
We were targeted for a lot of reasons, just like a lot of other Black organizations were. So we had challenges, just the greater society being threatened by us. Later, it was really just economics.
In 2014, the San Francisco store shuttered after predatory loans forced the family to sell their building. When the community raised $1.64 million to buy back the store, the developers refused to sell.
there's something about the liberalism that's really thick in San Francisco that can sometimes mask the operations of its anti-blackness. The Save Marcus Books campaign was really one about saving Black San Francisco.
But in Oakland, the gatherings continued. Maya Angelou, Muhammad Ali, Terry McMillan, Nikki Giovanni, Oprah Winfrey, and many others all held readings at Marcus Books.
I've never stopped coming. I've brought my granddaughters down here, and they get to see how great their people were and are.